calf raises are an easy exercise to do at home, and they work out your calf, which is this muscle here. There's a couple things you're going to need to do these calf raises. The first is a really sturdy calf raise stand, and later in the video I'll show you how to make one if you don't have one already. Second thing you need, a solid pair of shoes. If you have a pair that's falling apart, don't use them for this because you'll slide out of them. And the last thing you'll need is a dumbbell if your calves are strong. So let's cover the basic motion here. What you're going to do is put the balls of your feet over the calf stand, and you're going to go up slow and down slow. And you're going to go down until you feel a good comfortable stretch in your calf. You're not going to try to pull the muscle out of the joint. So you don't want to stretch too much, you'll get injured. So just up, down until you feel a comfortable stretch, and back up. And we're going to do this nice and slow. You see some people do this, or jumping up and down. This isn't a pogo stick, it's calf raises. So slow and controlled. So if you're just starting out, we're going to do it with 2 feet. So this is the beginner's calf raise. If you're a little more advanced, that's too easy. You can do it with 1 foot. And what you're going to do, notice I'm leaning against the wall to keep from falling over. That's important. So one hand on the wall, down and up. So this is an intermediate calf raise. If that's too easy for you, we're going to use a weighted calf raise. And what we're going to do, you're going to have the weight on the same side as the foot you're using. So if I'm going to do them with my left foot, I hold the weight in my left hand, balance the ball against with the right hand, and then just go up and down. That's all there is to it.
Hey, Mr. Tough Guy. What's with the pathetic calves? I don't even work out, and look at these massive puppies.
Well, Hans, thanks for pointing out my weak body part, but that does bring up an important point. There's no muscle that points out better the importance of genetics in bodybuilding than calves. Some people have them, some people don't. You'll notice there's some people who don't work out at all, and they've got these humongous calves. And then there's others who are bodybuilders. They've been working on calves for 10 years. They can do raises with 600 pounds, and they've got these little teeny weeny stick calves. It's just genetics. And it goes for other muscles too. Everybody has certain body parts that respond better to training than others. Nothing you can do about it. Now there's a question of how many, how often, if you're going to work out calves. And there's a lot of controversy on calves. Some people say that you should work out calves every day. And others say that it's like every other muscle and that you should just work it out once a week and work it out hard. Unfortunately, you're just going to have to try it for yourself and see what works best for you. My circumstance might be different than yours, but let me tell you what works best for me personally. I do a lot of running and cycling, which are calf intensive type exercise. So I only do calves once a week with weights. And when I do calves, I do them for about 20 minutes and I do heavyweight sets with reps in the range of 7 to 12. And what I'll do is I'll do a set, rest 60 seconds to 120 seconds, and then do another set and continue that for 20 minutes. Again, that's what works for me personally. You're going to have to try it out for yourself and see what works best for you. Okay, as promised, I'm going to show you how to make this calf raise stand. We're just going to use common 2x4s, some glue and nails, and that's all it's going to take. First, we're going to cut 2 pieces 10 inches long and 2 more pieces 20 inches long. So we'll start by doing the cutting. One very important point when you're building your calf raise stand is safety. You want to make sure that the height of the calf raise stand is not too high because you want to limit your range of motion to something safe. You want the height such that When you stand with your balls of your feet on the edge of the stand and relax, that your heels stretch down and touch the ground. That way, you'll limit your range of motion to something that's safe.
If it... When it's finished, this is what it's going to look like. It's going to be an H shape with two blocks on top and then the cross supports. Now, this has to be really sturdy. You don't want this falling apart when you're doing your calf raises. So we're going to use some good quality glue and nails to put this together. Nice liberal dose of glue. Sure it's nice and lined up. I'm going to make sure all the nails are in the right position before I pound them all the way home. Okay, it's looking pretty good, so now I can finish it up. Okay, now we have a nice H brace here, and we're going to put another block on top so it's higher. Again, we can't have this coming off, so we're going to glue and nail this. Again, we're going to use a liberal dose of glue because the glue is what really holds this thing together. The nails just hold it till the glue dries. Nice cushy coat, because we don't want this thing coming apart when we're doing our calf raises. Again, I'm going to just tack it in position before I nail all the nails completely in. There, done. So here's what the finished calf raise block looks like. And there's two more steps we're going to do to finish this off. First, if you're going to use this on a hardwood floor, you'll want to put some non-stick rubber bumpers on the bottom so you don't mar your floor, and also so that the whole block doesn't slide on the wood. I'm going to use it on carpet, so I'm going to skip that part. The second part is, when our shoes are on here, we don't want them sliding off the edge. So what we're going to do, we're going to take an old hacksaw blade and screw it to the edge here. And what that's going to do, that's going to give us a nice surface to grip on with our shoes so we don't slide off. And then we're done. And here's the completed product. You can see a close-up of the hacksaw blade, which is used for the shoe grip.
I'm really sorry about that wisecrack about your calves.